What's up everybody, this is Eric Reed Harry, and in this video I'm going to be showing how we built the double shell dome. And the reason I built the double shell dome is because it's a much faster process of building a aircrete dome than making bricks for domes. So if you're making a dome and you're using the brick method, you obviously have to have forms that you can pour aircrete into to make the bricks. And you're only going to be able to make but so many bricks in a day, you know, depending on how many forms you have. The great thing about this system is there are no bricks. What I'm doing in this building system is I'm making two thin shell domes with a cavity in the middle that I can then fill with aircrete. So what you've just seen is we were making the template, then cutting the Tyvek material and sewing it. And here you can see we're cutting the fiberglass mesh material. And the fiberglass mesh is one of the reinforcing layers that goes over your dome to reinforce it, to give it more strength. And that's another difference between this system and like the brick method. So the brick method, which is the system Dome Gaia teaches, there's not a lot of reinforcement at all. From what I'm told, there's only reinforcement on the bottom portion of the dome and just on the outside. Now I know guys that have put the reinforcement on the inside as well, and they say it's a very difficult job to put your reinforcing cloth and to stucco it on the inside. And the great thing about this is the dome shell is reinforced, and I can add as much reinforcement as I like. So for this workshop, I did something a little different than the domes that you see in the background. The domes you see in the back, they were made with the EPIC system, expanded polystyrene paper infused cement. So there's different recipes for the EPIC. There's different strengths and insulation layers that you can apply. But what we did for this smaller dome we're building is two stucco shells. So stucco being Portland cement and sand only. So the idea is, if you can't get the materials like I use for building the domes you see in the background there, which are paper and styrofoam, and you know, there's some places where you might have difficulty getting enough supply. So the beauty of this system is it only requires Portland cement and sand. So that's for your structural shell. And then for the cavity that we're creating by building two shells, we then fill with aircrete as our insulation material. Now you can see here, we've just finished pouring aircrete into this slab. So this is our aircrete slab. You have a concrete ring beam going all the way around, and we filled it with the aircrete slab. And you can see those PVC pipes right next to the foot there, right by the shovel, is our inflation pipes. So there's one on the outside where the blower gets hooked up to. Then you have one in the foundation and another on the inside. And so those are all for inflating the two air forms. This was the first time I actually did this system, and it worked really beautifully. Now what you see now is I'm using a bull float to float and to smoothen the aircrete. Now this aircrete has the Aircrete Harry thickening agent that you can get from aircreteharry.com. Without that thickening agent, this bull float would just sink to the bottom. So you saw we just finished pouring this and I'm bull floating it. The thickening agent makes the aircrete not only thicker so that you can pour taller pours, but it also strengthens the aircrete. And I'm really blown away. It really adds a lot more strength to your aircrete than not having it in the aircrete. And this is a clear example right here of me bull floating it. If you ever made aircrete and you know how like watery it is, how loose it is, especially after you just poured it, you'd never think about using a bull float. But the thickening agent, just two capfuls per 92, 94-pound bag of cement gets to the thickness that you need for your aircrete, and it's really good. So here's another one of my mixes. This has cement, sand, and a lot of fibers. And this second mix has mostly cement sand with no fibers. So this is how we build the hard coat on top of the aircrete, because the aircrete does not wear well. If you just had an aircrete surface, you walk on it, it would turn to dust. So you have to put a hard coat. So that was a very thin coat of reinforcing fibers with sand and cement. And then the second coating was sand, cement only. And I used a high plasticizer for that. So a super plasticizer, also known as water reducer, really adds to the strength of your cement. So you can see we're all celebrating finishing our ring beam and slab and prepping the angle iron that mounts the airform down. And so now we're in the process of mounting the first airform. And what we have here is a 10-foot diameter airform. So the inside of that dome, once complete, will be it'll be a 10-foot diameter. So the mesh is on the airform, and we're spraying the airform now with the first layers of cement. Now, we started this project with the sand cement mix, but because I wanted to also combine my other class where I'm built with Epic, we ended up switching to the Epic mix. But the idea is that this would be just sand and cement, and you'd use a $60 stucco sprayer to spray the material on. Here, this is the next day. The first day we did that first shell you see there. And day two, we're putting a second airform over that to then, here's the fiberglass mesh. This is our reinforcing mesh. And this really adds tons of strength to it. And you don't really have to stop there. You could spray a few layers of cement and then put another mesh over that. You know, whether it's this fiberglass mesh or a basalt mesh or a different fiberglass weave, you have a lot of options. Celebrating the second airform, inflation, mounting and inflating. We had a good time. This is Mrs. Aircrete. And here we're starting spraying the second airform. So as you saw, we have a stucco shell, sand cement shell on the inside, and now we're spraying the second shell on the outside. And this process is really fast. Like, we're doing a smaller dome, but this could easily be a 40-foot dome, and you could get it done in a day, especially, you know, during the summer when you have a lot of light and it's warm out. This could have easily been a 40-foot dome that we sprayed one day, and then the second day we did this. So here is the arch. So the way I build an arch, I just use masonite wood. And you can see the fiberglass here. We put a fiberglass mesh from the arch to the dome, and now I'm cementing it. So that's going to blend that archway into the dome shell to really give it a lot of structure and make it all monolithic. And it really adds a lot of strength to the archways. And so building this with this system really makes it quick. And using the masonite wood for the arch, we don't need to use any metal piping to make archways. You just simply take the wood and bend it to the shape you need, And there's other tips and tricks that I'll be offering in my online course on how to build a dome. Well, I'll be explaining in detail, along with a material list of everything you need to build a dome, whether it's with this system, which is the double shell system, or if you're going to be building with just the Epic mix, which is also another great system of building. So you can see there, we got the arch, the framework. It's a simple 2x4s, and we put bags of sand underneath it to get the height. And there were people that were worried about how the arch would be. And once I showed how simple it was to do, they were very relieved that they would be able to make a nice archway. And you can use that same system like let me show you right here, where it now began to fill the cavity with aircrete. And you could use the archway for making your hallways and other things like that.
Okay, so this is the aircrete dome I built during one of the workshops. And it's not complete. Still have some more work to do. We've just been very busy around here. So this dome is a double shell dome. So there is an inner shell and an outer shell. The reason that was done is so that the cavity in between the two shells could be filled with aircrete. Now this is the second time I've done this. The first time I've done this was about 4 years ago back in New York. And I'll leave a link in the description box below so you can see the original idea for this double shell system. So this is the first time I completed one that was permanent. The one I built in New York, I had to demolish because there was no building permit for it. It was just an experimental prototype. So with this one, what we've done is we built an airform that went on the inside. So we'll go on the inside here. So the airform was mounted here, inflated. The airform is gone. This is just some of it stuck to the cement. The wall comes out extremely smooth because of the Tyvek airform is so smooth that you have no finishing work to do on the inside. Actually, we do get some wrinkles like this, but this is easily able to be plastered and made smooth. But the majority of the wall is completely smooth. Like, you could just paint and be done. So there's no scraping or filing or smoothing out the wall on the inside like a traditional aircrete dome, because this is a stucco shell. So that's cement and sand. And it comes out perfectly smooth here. So that's a big benefit to using the airform, is to not have to do any finishing work on the inside when we peel the airform off. But we inflated an airform, and then we sprayed it with cement. So the idea behind this dome is to only use cement and sand for the shell, for the two shells, and then aircrete for your inside. So I had a couple issues with this dome. This is a prototype again. So the first issue we had was when we built this first one, we built this wall very thin. I always build the walls that's going to be by the doorway very thin, and then we build up the thickness as we move away. Because I'm going to cut through this, no sense in making this thick when I'm just going to cut through it. So the issue I had was I made it too thin. You can see how thin it is here. It's like super thin. So when I poured this aircrete, and you can see I had a hose coming down here, and it filled this cavity up. So it was filling it, and the weight of the aircrete pushed this in, and I had aircrete leak out into the floor here. So that was my first mistake, was to not spray it thick enough to make it strong enough. If I sprayed it like maybe this thick here for this whole doorway area, it would have been good enough to hold the weight of the aircrete back. But in this case, it didn't. So this was a big learning lesson. I'm going to still be able to finish this dome, but because of the issues I had here, I just stopped. And I'm just going to get back to this later. Probably during the winter, I'll work on this because I need to chip this away. I need to close this off and then finish filling on the inside. But the concept works beautifully. Everything works, minus the mistakes. So long as you don't make that mistake, it'll be perfect. So after building the shell for this inner dome, I then and just so you know, this is a 10-foot diameter. So the inside of this dome here is 10 foot. That's the inflation tube. That's the tube I use to fill the air in here to inflate the airform. So this is a 10 foot and this is an 11 foot. So ideally, you'll have a 6-inch cavity in between the two domes. So again, the beauty of this system is with sand and cement, a mortar mix, you can stucco spray with a stucco sprayer the dome shell. Then we put a second airform over this. And by the way, this has a mesh as well. This is the fiberglass mesh. So it had an airform and a mesh over it. Then that was sprayed. So that reinforces it. You can see a crack, but it stays stuck to the mesh. And then we put the second airform. This is the second airform that was used to make this dome. And you can see the walls come out pretty smooth. This might be a little bit rough from the aircrete pouring in here, but I'll show you in this wall in a moment. And this was during a workshop. So this was a test we did during the workshop. So now we sprayed this, that cured, set up. Next day, we put the second airform over it. We mounted it to the ground and we inflated the second airform and then we sprayed this. And you can see the thickness here. Again, this is the doorway. So by the doorway, we always make it thinner because we're going to be cutting through this. Past this point here, past the archway, the cement gets much thicker. It gets up to like an inch and a half thick. An inch to an inch and a half thick on the rest of the shell. So the purpose of this is to make a structure that you could build anywhere and be code compliant. Now, the reason this would be code compliant is because you have a cement mortar mix, right? That's reinforced with fabric, as well as you could use rebar. This mix happens to also have PVA fibers as well as basalt fibers in it. So we have two fibers mixed into this cement. So we had our two shells and then we filled with aircrete. So technically, you could build this structure in 5 days. It would only take you 5 days to build it. And this would be under $1,000. So if you look at, you could use this as a shed, you could use it as a spare room. So if you were to buy a shed, for example, at like Home Depot or Lowe's, this size, you'd be paying way over $1,000, and it would just be for wood. You would have no insulation. So I'll just say again, this dome is not finished. This will be a porthole window when it's complete. The window will be made much bigger than this. I just cut this opening to see the inside of here. So this is aircrete. So the aircrete, it's about 4 feet high all the way around. You can see this is about 4 feet high all the way around here. And it's approximately 6 inches thick all the way around. And this is an insulative mix, which means we use a lot of air in the mix. So this is like about a 60-gallon mix. So it's about 53 gallons of foam added to one bag of cement. And that's what we have here. So we filled this cavity. Here's a great example of the thickness of the shell. So this shell, for the workshop I was having here, I wanted to teach the Epic Mix. So instead of just using sand cement, we use the Epic Mix. The Ironwood Mix is what we used to make these two shells. And you can see this outer shell is much thicker. It's about a half inch thick. It's solid. It's definitely solid at about a half inch thick. This one here is about a quarter inch thick. And so this was the inner shell. That's the outer shell. And then from the top, I'll show you where that clamp is. I made a hole in the top. So that's where we stuck a hose in to fill this up with aircrete. And these arches were very simple to make. So once I made the form, I took this mesh, and this mesh goes all the way over this way and this way. So it's all cemented to make it all monolithic. It's all one piece. And again, you're looking at an unfinished project here. But it's just to give you the idea that you can build using just cement and sand. You could build your shell, and then using just Portland cement, you can make your aircrete. And this happens to be the aircrete made with a thickening agent. So it's much stronger than regular aircrete without the thickening agent. So once the outside is complete, we're going to have a stucco coating over all of this. This will all be stucco coated. We'll be using a white Portland cement with a cement dye to give it color. And then we'll smoothen it out. But yeah, I just wanted to demonstrate, just show and demonstrate how the dome was made with aircrete and cement. And it's a very fast project. You know, once you make your airforms, which will take you about 1 to 2 days alone to make your airforms, you can you can have your structure up in no time for very little money. And it's fireproof, it's insulated with 6 inches of aircrete. The arch shell, if you watch the video, I'm gonna show how we built this, and you'll see how this was made. This was extremely simple. In fact, I'll just give you an example. Again, this is obviously unfinished, but for example, here we just use some pallets as a formwork, and we take masonite and just bend it into an arch. So you can make it different widths. And this one here is about 4 feet wide, this archway. And then it's covered in a mesh and then sprayed. Again, we're using the Epic Mix for this, but you could use just sand and cement if you're somewhere where you don't have your styrofoam and paper. See, this is some of the PVA fibers here that are all in this mix, giving it a lot more structure. And then what happens is we'll cover it with a stucco wire mesh. And that's not finished, but that's the piece that's going to go over the top and just merge this arch shell to the dome structure. And that'll all be cemented, and it'll become monolithic. It'll become very solid, super strong. This stucco wire mesh is incredibly strong. So this is just an example of how the arches are made using just a simple piece of masonite that we bend. We don't need to use tubing or PVC pipes or anything. The masonite is the perfect material for bending into an arch. And so that here's I was experimenting with another Epic Mix that we put on here, and it's pretty solid. Again, this dome's not finished. It needs the insulative mix for it to be finished. The structural layer is already on. We've sprayed all the structural mix, and so structurally it's sound. What it's missing now is about 8 inches of insulation that'll come all the way out to here, and that'll insulate the entire dome. So I'll make a new video once I've completed this to show you the completed finished dome. But again, this is a 10 foot diameter on the inside, 11 foot on the outside, double shell dome with the archway. I'll just show you the floor. I'll walk across here. So from here, another thing I'll demonstrate is by making these stem walls, I can stand right next to this dome without the curvature hitting my head. So that's one of the benefits of the stem wall. If I made it just as a hemispherical dome, the peak would be too low. And this curvature, you know, I'd probably be standing about this far from the wall because of the curvature. Now, that would probably be fine for some situations as cabinet space or something where you didn't need to be against the wall. But I liked the fact that I can be standing right next to the wall and not have my head hit. So I'm about 5'8", 5'8", and it's not hitting. So if you were 6 feet, you'd probably be just touching your head. And just as an example, 1, 2, 3, 4 steps across. Again, this is a 10-foot diameter dome, so that means it's 10 feet from this end to that end, straight across. Oh, lastly, I'll show you the inflation tube. You can't see how I did it, but I built the second tube that inflates the other airform in between the two shells. So I built that into the foundation. And this is where the inflation tube, there was a tube that came up. It got filled with cement. But the tube, the air, got pumped into here and inflated the two shells, the two airforms. Anyway, this is Zachary Harry. Peace out. Love you all, and I'll catch you later.